guys, it's Captain Harris again, like 24 hours later, and we're on our way to our next concert, which is Gojira, Knocked Loose, and Alien Weaponry, and that's at the Hard Rock Live in Orlando, Florida. So that's one of my favorite venues. We haven't been there in a long time, since before the pandemic, so really looking forward to being back and showing you guys around and having a great time tonight.
So we will see you there.
We will.
How many people do you think are in this car?
12. I mean the age.
So, it's, this place is in the Universal Studios resort here, and it's, technically it's $27 to park, but...
Before 6 o'clock.
Before 6
o'clock. On non-holiday nights.
It's Halloween Horror Nights tonight, so it is not free parking.
Yeah, it's... Before 10 o'clock, you have
but,
to pay $27.
There's a hack to that. Instead of paying $27, I actually paid $400 to get an annual pass here where you get free parking, so I just saved $27.
Sick.
The best thing about going to a show in a place like this is you can get dinner at like 50 different places.
For $50.
$50, but you 50 different entrees in City Walk.
Cool thing about Hard Rock is that it's right between Islands of Adventures and Universal Studios, so if you ever travel to come see a show here, it would probably be worth doing a day at the parks as well.
Get a day pass, go on Hagrid's, go on Lost Coaster, go on E.T.
Oh, yeah.
And then get a milkshake.
It's just a real fun place in general to go see shows.
Found the opening band Alien Weaponry's merch table actually outside. We didn't see that coming in.
Oh, Zealand. I want to see one thing happen. I want to see that fucking mosh pit start. You guys think you can do that? Alright, this song is called Fucking Real.
When Alien Weaponry's turned America, they did Chicago Open Air. festival is a big one day, 3 day festival. I forget what it was, but on the same day it was Gojira, Eli Rep, a bunch of bands, right? So the festival, the green rooms were all like sometimes camp set up, sometimes like the last night was at.
Thank you. guys doing so far? Thank you. You guys look happy. I heard a few days ago Orlando's crowd sucks. I don't know. I don't see it. You don't suck at all. It's actually quite the opposite. You guys are fucking amazing. Thank you so much. I was down in Tampa the day they said that just right home. We knew it wasn't true. We knew it wasn't true. It's not our first time in Orlando. Would you like to hear another song from the album 42? We'll be right back. So I'll tell you straight up, we're gonna play that song called The Chant off our new album. But yeah, it's happening. So there's no way I'm singing that chorus, right? Because there's like a million voices on this. And so we need you guys to sing the chorus for us. This is gonna be fucking great. Are you ready for this? Give me that note. Stuff like this, all right? But some of you could go, this is the longest set, you know, we've ever played on this tour, and it goes by so fucking quickly. It feels like 5 minutes, doesn't it? You guys were unbelievable. Thank you so much for buying your tickets and showing up to support live music. Thank you for Alien Weaponry and for Knock Loose and for our entire crew. We're a big family on the road and we're having a blast. Thank you so much for making this possible for all of us. Thank you. Show of the tour so far, man! so much, Orlando.
No, I was being pushed up, and I was like, if people are gonna push me,
so it's the next day after the show, and doing the usual, I'm gonna give our thoughts. So let's go ahead and start with Alien Weaponry.
Yeah, we got there just in time to see them, and right when we walked in, we ended up meeting
one of our friends
that's working the show and the tour, and he was really cool. And
he gave us a lot of information about the band, and you know, kind of got us interested in checking them out a bit more. So their show was really good, I thought.
For Alien Weaponry.
Yeah. And something cool is he mentioned that they sing some of their songs in their native language are from New Zealand. So that's, you know, that's a unique thing about them. So we'll definitely be checking them out a bit more.
Yeah, they had a pummeling bass drum sound, and they were a three-piece, but they sounded much bigger than that.
Yeah, I mean, you've got some killer three pieces out there like Motorhead, so,
and
you
quite
know.
Quite impressive vocal performance, actually.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah,
definitely a cool band to keep your eye on, Alien Weaponry.
Yeah, we'll be checking them out further, but moving on to Knocked Loose. I've never been a hardcore person, so
it's like a metalcore band. They look pretty young.
Yeah, for sure.
Apparently they're heavy on the festival circuit.
So, yeah, I'm not really big into hardcore, so did nothing for me, but I really liked watching them work the crowd, because my cousin who likes them, he was like, the last time I saw them, there was nowhere to escape in the venue. Like, the entire place was just moving and moshing and jumping around.
Everybody has a cousin who loves metalcore.
Yes, and he wasn't lying. At one point, I posted in the video, people were just, the whole floor was just jumping and pushing and shoving.
Yeah, it was from front to back, everyone was going wild.
And that was entertaining for me, at least. So I got to, you know, laugh and have fun watching the crowd.
As far as the band, it's pretty much just breakdowns all the way through.
Yeah, I'm not into that stuff.
I don't know, to me the vocal kind of killed it.
Yeah.
It's just not my thing.
Not mine either, but all the power to you if that's what you like. And Gojira, obviously, this was our first headlining show for Gojira. We saw them open for Slipknot in 2019, and then they played Knotfest just last month. So this was our third time seeing them, and it was fantastic. The guitar tones were perfect. The sound where we were at, we were stage right off to the side after we were in the middle first, and it got crazy, and I strong-armed James out. I'm like, okay, after Slipknot yesterday, I'm not dealing with this.
Yeah, when they played, what was their first song?
Their first song was Born for One Thing, and that was very tame. We got to stand there. You filmed most of it.
We were able to film, and then that song ended, and they started to play Backbone.
And all hell broke loose. And I don't mind the pushing and shoving, but when the nonstop crowd surfers kept coming over, I'm like, we've got to get out of here. I turned around and I saw a crowd surfer get, like, thrown and fall on the people next to us. I'm like, I'm not staying up here. I don't have the...
I got kicked in the face a couple of times.
I don't have the energy for this after the show we saw last night. So we moved over to the side, and the sound was really great over there, and could see everything just fine. So we had a great time.
The band sounded monumental. They had
CO2
canisters. CO2 canisters just blasting.
Awesome.
I mean, it's crazy, like, the height those things can get.
Yeah, and the light show they had was great and everything, so.
Yeah, lots of strobes, so be careful.
So we had a really good time. It was nice to finally see them headline, and lots of songs on Fortitude, which I was very happy for, because I've been listening to that a lot since it came out.
Such a good album.
Yeah, the chant was really fun. Our cousin who was in the middle, obviously we talked, he saw Knock Loose with us. He came over, he's like, I can't do that anymore, I just want to do the chant with you guys. So that was fun. So yeah, we had a really great time.
I'm happy that we don't have a concert tonight.
Yeah, so we're just gonna relax, and our next show will be Metallica, Mastodon, Anthrax, and more at Welcome to Rockville. So we're looking forward to that, and we'll be vlogging that, so we'll see you guys then. And that's about all I got to say for this one.
Till the next time.
Till the next time.